Welcome back. You're still watching Morning Rush on Metro Television. You know, every Friday we have a discussion with Dr. Prince Osei from Medimosis, who is the PRO. And today we are talking about something more feminine. We are talking about understanding menstrual cramps. And it's funny that at this time we are talking about menstrual cramps. Anyway, Doc, how are you?
I'm well, man.
It's good to have you.
Doc is saying that. Yeah. You know the symptom.
You know they see Christmas.
Yeah, the Christmas.
I don't believe it. But then, Doc, last week when you were here, we were talking about this free screening. How did it go?
Oh, it went very well. It went very well. And I think we screened almost 400 people. Mm. Yeah, last Saturday. Mm. So it was a good thing.
It was a good thing.
As I said last week, you know, it's the screening that makes us. It helps us give.
You become aware
picture.
Of the part of the population that needs.
Yeah, because. From what we did, we had about a little above 50 having a bit of a medical issue.
Okay.
Yeah, so 50% having a bit of a medical issue. So it means that if we take every 10 people, about 5 of them or even more have medical problems that they are not aware of. Yeah, so it's a good thing we did this, and I'm sure Ghanaians have benefited from it.
Moving forward, you can solve the situation.
Be more free stuff.
Doc, this one we are looking at menstrual cycle. Mm-hmm. It's part of every woman. And it comes with a lot of things. But then, let's start with the general one, the cramps. Yeah. That's a major problem.
Yeah.
Is it normal for every woman to experience menstrual cramp?
Yeah. You say you don't know why we are talking about it at this time, but we want the ladies to enjoy the Christmas, you know.
So most of us are last but one.
You see, menstrual cramps mostly is not so much of a normal thing. It shouldn't, you are allowed to have some bit of pain, but it shouldn't be so painful to the extent that you can't do anything. We have some women at that time of the month, they can't do anything. They can't go to work. They can't even get up from bed sometimes. Some people have pains in the legs, vomiting, nausea, and all that. Yeah, so sometimes it can be very unbearable. Mm-hmm. Most of the times, you may have some bit of mild pain in your lower abdomen, which can be considered normal. But if it goes forward, like it moves on to start causing you this nausea, vomiting, weakness in the legs and all that, then it becomes a bit of a problem. Yeah. So it's normal, but not so normal if you have those things. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the causes of the menstrual cramps. I know a holy one.
Which is
if you don't have some amount of blood in the system, it can cause that you feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Maybe the other ones that you can share.
So let's take it from where you started, you know. Every organ in the body must have a blood supply. So if one particular organ is not getting enough blood supply, you start having that pains. It's like sometimes, you know, when you sleep, you can sleep on your hands and
become numb.
We call it anase. Yeah. You see, it's a bit uncomfortable. Yeah, so if you have an internal organ experiencing such thing, you may have that pains. So in the body, the female have about 4 or 5 hormones controlling fertility. We have the follicle stimulating hormone, which matures the eggs, and we have the luteinizing hormone releasing the egg. So if there is no fertilization or you've not met with a man for fertilization to take place, another hormone called the prostaglandin comes into place. So it's the prostaglandin that squeezes the uterus, so it presses on the uterus to cause the blood that the egg that was released and the uterus that was preparing for the child to come to shed. So that is what comes out as blood. So as I said, every man may have that bit of uncomfortable because of the squeezing of the uterus, but in some women the prostaglandin levels are so high that the uterus squeeze so much to prevent blood flow to the uterus. So if there is that shorting blood flow to the uterus, then it means that the uterus wouldn't be getting enough blood supply. Definitely you start having those pains. So as you rightly said, if you have reduced blood in your system, generally, like if you're anemic too, it means that the uterus wouldn't be getting enough blood supply when it squeezes. So it means that you have those pains. But there are some women who may have enough blood, but because of the prostaglandin levels being so high, it squeezes so much that it presses on the blood supply that goes to the uterus. Mm-hmm. And it means that the uterus wouldn't be getting enough blood at that time. And you start having those pains. So that is the process that goes on within the woman body at that time of the month. So the hormones that causes you to be able to be fertile, that's the same hormone that can also cause these problems. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so you've talked about the causes. Now, to the woman and also to us, so that we can know what our women should be. I understand if you don't eat right, mm-hmm. it affects all of those things. Mm-hmm. You can just take us through that.
Yeah, so eating the right way is the same as what we mentioned. If you don't get enough blood supply, so if you are eating well, then it means that your body will get enough blood supply to prevent this. But if you are not eating well, it can cause that. And sometimes hormonal changes, hormonal imbalances can cause that. So there are some women who may be using some of these emergency pills, emergency hormonal contraceptives, that can cause the hormones to be imbalanced. So as I mentioned, the prostaglandin is the main hormone that causes the uterus to squeeze itself so that the blood will come out. So if you have hormonal imbalance, it means that the prostaglandin levels too could shoot up abnormally, mm-hmm. and it can also cause some of these pains. So some of these activities, not eating well, abuse of hormonal contraceptives, mm-hmm. especially the emergency ones, and also some lifestyle modifications, like some lifestyle changes, alcohol abuse, eating so much of fatty foods and all that, could be causes of menstrual cramps. Okay. Yeah.
Are there types, mm-hmm. or is just it's just only one?
Yeah, just the pain.
Yeah, we have types. We have types actually. We have the primary and we have the secondary. So there are some women that don't have any underlying medical condition, mm-hmm. so they don't have any medical issue, but then they'll start having these menstrual cramps. Mostly it starts from the manic, like the first time that you start having your menses. There are some young ladies who from the time they started their menses have been having painful menstruation throughout every month. Is every month they start
and is that
having
normal?
That. It's not normal.
Okay.
It's not normal. But most of them, you check them and there is no really an underlying condition. Mm-hmm. They don't have any uterine abnormality. Their uterus is okay and all that. But then they start having that. It could probably be due to hormonal imbalance. Mm-hmm. Mostly, you may not be able to detect the hormonal imbalance in that early stage because that is when the body is now developing. So there are some ladies, there are some young ladies that the hormones, the prostaglandin levels will be high at that time of the month and it causes those pains. Okay. But as I mentioned earlier, if the pain is something that you can bear, that is fine. But if it gets to the point that you can't do anything about, you are vomiting, you are missing classes and all that, then it becomes, a bit of issue. Yeah. We've been having some of these cases at all, and that was why I wanted to talk about it.
No, there are a lot of people that I know who go through.
Yeah,
people have to lie on the floor and you have to put this.
But like Doc said, when you are growing, it has to change. Because one of my major problem was that when it comes, my waist becomes rigid, it locks. Like it becomes rigid, it locks. I can't
sweep.
Yeah,
times.
Yes. Yeah. But then from age 22 coming, it stopped.
Yeah. Sometimes it goes on its own, but there are some that can go on. There are some that can go on. Especially, and if it happens like that, some people too may start developing some conditions within the uterus. Mm-hmm. That one can lead to what we call the secondary cause of the menstrual cramps. As I mentioned, the earlier, the primary one being having no underlying condition, but we can have the secondary one. The secondary one can result from a condition that we call there are certain conditions of the uterus, like fibroids, for instance. Mm-hmm. If you start developing fibroids, it means that when the uterus is contracting, the fibroids within the uterus too can start causing pain for you. So in this time around, it's not lack of blood supply, but there is something within the uterus that is causing it to cause that pain. Imagine you having something in your hands and you are squeezing it. You feel that pain. So if there is fibroid within the uterus and the uterus is contracting, it means that you start having that pain. So that one, if you don't treat the underlying cause, it means that you'll be having it. So some women or some young women start having the primary cause of the menstrual cramps. But later on, it can develop into the secondary. So as you said, with yours, maybe the primary one resolved on its own. So, and it didn't develop into the secondary one. So with that, as you are aging, it goes. But when it develops into the secondary one, then it means that the primary one may be resolved, but then the secondary one too can start causing the pain. And we have something that we call endometriosis. That is when the line of the uterus are found other side at some parts of the uterus. The lining should be within the uterus, but there are some women that have some of the cells of the line developing around the uterus. So it means that you start having abnormal bleeding. So like when the uterus squeezes, those lining that are around the uterus also starts to squeeze. So it means the squeezing will be too much, and it can also start causing these pains.
I was just going to ask, how do one relieve herself of the pain?
Relieve ourselves from the pain?
But it's pain.
So every man, let's leave it to them.
You know, funny enough, most women start to take something that we call NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. And the side effects of NSAIDs is so much. Like, it can cause peptic ulcer disease, it can cause some issues within the body. And the funny thing is the prostaglandin that I mentioned, the NSAIDs stops the prostaglandin from working. So prostaglandin is what makes you feel the pain. So when you take the NSAIDs, the pathway of the NSAID is it stops the production of the prostaglandin. So it means that the uterus wouldn't squeeze enough and the blood wouldn't flow well. So there are most women, as soon as they take the painkiller, the blood stops coming. And when the blood stops coming to you, disrupted the normal process that was supposed to go on within the body.
So you've got to
endure.
Not really endure, but there are some relief. There are some products that you can take that will regulate the prostaglandin levels. That should be the focus of the treatment. Not really taking painkillers to let the pain go. But if you are able to regulate the prostaglandin levels or the hormonal levels, then it means that subsequent months you wouldn't be feeling that pain so much. And that is where Femacare X comes in. So as I mentioned, Femacare X is always it's for hormonal imbalances.
It's a 360
it's for hormonal imbalance. So when you start taking it, what it does, it regulates the prostaglandin level. So it wouldn't cause the body to release so much of a prostaglandin. So if you have the primary cause of the menstrual cramps, then you start taking the Femacare X, it means the likelihood of it developing to the secondary one wouldn't be there. It wouldn't develop because it solved the hormonal issues. And is that hormonal issue that may have led to you having fibroids, you having these endometriosis, and you having these polycystic ovarian syndrome and all the other causes. So if you take it, it means that the body will be relieved of the menstrual pain, but the blood will still be coming. Yes, the normal blood that should come will still be coming. But this time around, the hormone that would have caused it to squeeze so much will be regulated. So you wouldn't be having so much of the pain that you used to feel. So Femacare X is available in all pharmacies. When you are a woman and you start experiencing this, you take it before even the menses comes. It's not a painkiller. So you don't take it one when you are feeling the pain. So what we advise is if you have that problem, you start taking it like 3 days to your menstrual cycle. If you know that, let's say you start your menses on the 20th, you start taking it from the 17th of the month, so that by the time that the menses starts coming, the hormone will be regulated and you wouldn't be having any of these problems.
Yeah. Before we go, we spoke about infertility and stuff. Can these cramps cause infertility? And there's one major question. Jennifer, floor member, says I should ask. So let's answer the infertility
It's possible it can cause. It's possible because when you start having, especially with the primary one, when you start having these menstrual cramps, it means that, as I mentioned, it can lead to endometriosis, mm-hmm. it can lead to polycystic ovaries, it can lead to fibroid. So when it leads to any of these conditions, you know, these ones are major things that can prevent a woman from getting pregnant, mm-hmm. especially the polycystic ovaries. If you have polycystic ovaries, it means that your ovaries wouldn't be working as it should. The egg wouldn't be released mm-hmm. when it should. So it means that even if you have sex, the egg wouldn't be there to meet with the sperm. So okay. it can lead to infertility. If you have fibroids, if it covers the uterus too, it means you wouldn't be able to have a child. If you have endometriosis too, it can cause. So these menstrual cramps that you're having that you feel is normal could lead to some of these infertility issues in the near future.
Yeah. I thought it was normal, though. Jennifer says I should ask, when you're having your menstruation, is it good to have sex before, during, or after?
I didn't get it.
When you're in your menstrual mm-hmm. period, mm-hmm. is it good to have sex during or after?
Before, during after? Your menstrual period.
Yes. Oh. That is what Jennifer said.
No, Jaren is out. So, Jaren is out. So after,
are you the doctor?
Okay, so medically, though, there is nothing wrong with it.
Oh.
Jaren.
Yes, medically, there is nothing. Just that during that time, you are so prone to having infections.
Uh-huh.
So, if you, the woman, has any form of infection, you can easily transmit it to your man.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. It's not advisable. But yeah. I had this couple that was having issue with fertility, and unfortunately, the woman ovulates whilst menstruating.
Mm-hmm.
So we tried everything; it wasn't working. So what I had to do was to call the husband in and advise. I'd read somewhere that there are some women like that mm-hmm. who ovulate whilst menstruating.
Yeah.
So I talked to them that we should give it a try. They did it for the first man, the second man, the woman got pregnant.
Oh, okay.
So it confirmed that yeah. there are some women who may be ovulating mm-hmm. whilst menstruating. So
because ovulation has to happen first.
Yes.
Then the menstruation yes, will
yes,
come.
Yes.
You get it. But this one is in. It's, so mm-hmm. the husband has yeah. had to buy.
That is why with fertility, mostly I don't advise women to go with a normal calendar. You know, there is this calendar that every woman uses that, yeah. this is my free period.
No,
not everyone.
There's an app.
Not everyone. Yeah,
you, sometimes it can
me,
feel.
I don't use app. I use diary. I take.
That's the school for you. Okay, no. So in all of this, Femacure, yeah. that is
Femacure, 360 for women.
Yes, yes. Yeah. But if it's very severe, you can come to any of
the
our
center.
Branches.
Yeah.
You can come to Adenta, you can come to a J. Kojo behind the school for the deaf. Mm-hmm. If you're in Kumasi, you can go to Ahinima Kokobin. If you're in Accra Central, you can go to the AESL building, the Ministry of Road and Highway. We have our branches there so that we can get checked. Because if there is an underlying cause, then it means the underlying cause has to be treated before you can be completely free.
Okay. No, thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.
But somebody, is it hot water?
Yeah, hot water? The hot water bottle too is
what does it do?
You put hot water in a bottle, then you put it on your lower abdomen.
Ah.
So what it does, it thins the blood. Oh. So it means that the blood will be able to flow well.
Hey, I didn't know that.
I'll touch you that one.
Yeah, so that sometimes it's one of the home remedies. Oh, yeah, it's sometimes so. But there are some women who do it, but it's still not working.
Okay, Dr. President, thank you so much for coming. Wish you a Merry Christmas.
But the December money is The money is in. Just like the money is in, but you know the sweet talk.
The money finished before
it
came.
Or you are holding it for January.
It finished before it came.
Oh. No, thank you for coming. Merry Christmas to you. And hopefully we'll see you next year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was Dr. Praise Osei from Edumosis.